Hello guys, we are here again. In this video, I will teach you a three pop box you will usually see in JavaScript. There is a lot of pop box in JavaScript, a lot. But in this video, I will just mention a three principal pop box you will usually see in JavaScript. That are alert box, pop box, and confirm box. Let's start defining what is alert box. Alert box is used when you want to ensure that information gets to the user. It means like when alert box pops up, the user must click OK to proceed this action. Another way you can say alert box is used to display an alert box containing a message and an OK button. That's called as alert box. Let's take a simple example to understand this concept. Right here, the right here function will give my function name a message. Right here I will open my curly braces. Then inside I will write alert. I will open my parentheses. And right here I will write the information I want to see. And welcome to my page. Then right here, semicolon. Then I need to call this function message. Then here, save. Come to your browser. Click right here. Something is wrong right here. Yes. It's later. It's uppercase and this is lowercase. So okay, I know. Then right here to work. Then we have here welcome to my page. This information will get to the user, and the user must click OK in order to proceed this action. Now that's called an alert box. Let me just click OK here. Then I will do whatever I want to do. This is the alert box. Let's move on to the next pop box. That is a prompt box. What is a prompt box? A prompt box, it's used to create a dialog box with the user to enter an input. It means like the user must input a value before entering a page. You know, that's called as a prompt box. Let's take an example to understand this concept. We just delete here. Write your function value. You're gonna write var x equal. If you guys don't know what is a var, this var right here. This var right here is a variable, and this x right here is my variable name. And right here I will give this variable name a variable value that I will right here prompt. Open the parentheses. Inside I will write this information like please enter your name. Again, semicolon. Again, right here, document dot write and x. If I don't write the document right here, the information or the values I will put right here will not show on my page. That's why I need to write this document dot write in order to see my result. Again, right here, I need to call this function value, then semicolon, save right here, come to your browser, refresh. Then right here we have our sprint box. Then this is the information I put, and right here I will put the values I want. If I don't put the values, it will show now. Let's see, we'll click here, cancel. You see, now. Now it means like you didn't put any value. That's why it's shown now. Then I will refresh again. I will put the values. We will write stranger. Then OK. Then right here, it's my values, you know. If I didn't write the document dot write, my values will not show. Let me just delete this. Save. Come up here. Flash. Then right here, stranger. Okay. It's nothing right here because we deleted a document dot write. You know, if you deleted your document dot write, it means your values will not appear here. That's why we are seeing there is nothing right here.
Let's move on to the last pop box. That is a confirm box. What does mean confirm box? Confirm box, the user must verify or accept something. The meaning, like, when a confirm box pops up, the user must click either OK or cancel to proceed his action. That's called as a confirm box. Let's take an example to understand this concept. It's right here, function. Give this function a name, con, open the curly braces, write var result equal confirm. Inside this parenthesis, and we'll write this information right here. Do you want to leave this page? Then semicolon. Then right here I need to create a condition for this statement. Right, if, and this is result. Equal true. If you guys don't understand what is this operator, this operator, it means equal to, you know, it's comparing something. Then right here inside of these curly braces we'll write alert right here, thanks for visiting. and semicolon, then here else. Alert. Thanks for staying with us. Then right here, semicolon. Then I need to call this function right here. Then call this function. Then go to your browser, refresh. Then right here we have confirm box. Right here, if you click OK, it means you will leave this page. That's it. You know, thanks for visiting. It means you'll leave this page. Let's click right here again. If you click on sell, it means you will stay. That's why we say here, thanks for staying with us. That's right here. So if you guys like this video, if you have any doubt, just comment, because I'm here to help you. Any kind of doubt, just comment. I'm here to help you. See ya. Peace.